Welcome at A-Create, the channel for game enthusiasts. In this video, I show you how easy it is to make your own menu in Game Maker Studio 2 with only drag and drop. Let's start with opening a new project and select drag and drop. Create a new sprite for the button. We will change the size to 128 by 128. If you are not yet sure about the size, is it essential to use the standard sizes of 32, 64, 128, because this makes scaling a lot easier. And don't forget to rename the button. Making your own button isn't so hard, so we are going to make our own. Click on Edit Image to open the edit settings. Make a rectangle shape and use the circle tool to give it some natural bevel on the sides. Move the whole object with the selector tool. Use the paint bucket tool to fill the shape to make it into one object, solid object. And use the paint bucket tool again to fill it with another color. I will make a new layer for the text and the shadow. This to make it easier to change things when we duplicate the buttons. Select the text tool and select the white color and adjust the font settings on top. These are basically the basic to make a play button. You can add more texture and shadows and bevels and so on. Now we will use this sprite to make the play button. Select create new object, rename it and assign the play button. Add the event left mouse button left press and drag in the go to the next room icon. To make this function work, we will first need to create a new room. So we have another room to go to. In the first room, we will drag in the player button. Make sure that you have selected the layer for instances to be able to drag objects into the room. You can resize the button by just dragging the handlers and hold a control to resize it the width and the height with the same scale and numbers. Now we will make the button to quit the game. Copy the sprite of the player button with Ctrl D. Rename and open the edit image settings. Click on your default layer and use the paint bucket tool to change the green into another color. Delete also the type of player and just write in the quit. Now we can make the quit button functional. Select new object, rename, assign the sprite, and on the event mouse button press, you should drag in the function exit game. Be sure to select exit game, which will close the application in itself. Drag in the button into the first room and run the application to check if it's working. Perfect! Now we can make the two buttons for save and load. Duplicate one of the button sprites, rename and open its edit image settings as before. Change its color and the text. Don't forget to play around with what you like. Duplicate the load button, rename and make in the same way the savings button. Let's make new objects for the new buttons. Make a new object for the save button. Rename, assign a sprite, and in the event mouse button left press drag, we will drag in save game. You will see the name of the file would be the standard save.dat. So GameMaker will make and add this file into your database of your game. Now we will do the same with the load button. Make a new object, rename it, assign a sprite, and in its events mouse button press, we drag in the load game function, which makes contact with the same save.dat file. Let's get back to the room and drag in the load button into the scene. You can uncheck snap to move it in the room without any restriction. And drag the save button into the other room. To be able to test all of our buttons, we need to make an executable. Click on build create executable and package the file and save it on your computer. Okay, now you can check your menu when you open your executable. I love how easy it is in Game Maker to make such a simple menu. This was A-Create. Hope you liked this tutorial. Subscribe for more tutorials in the future. See you in the next one. Make more, enjoy more.